What's up, YouTube? Andy from the Sports Card Flip Game here with the latest on how to get you plugged in to all things sports cards. In today's video, we are going to be doing another Mail Day opening, but with a twist this time. We are going to be talking about three investment strategies for new investors. We are going to talk about how you can take sports cards to the next level by using some very basic entry-level investment strategies. So without further ado, let's get into it. There are three investment strategies that I think will work very well for new investors into sports cards. And very simply, they are to first look for lots or buy lots of specific players, and we'll talk about that. Buy overlooked players or sets. And by that, I mean look to different cards that aren't the traditional rookie cards of key players, or look at maybe their second year cards, things like that, or memorabilia cards. And third, find deals. Look and scour eBay for those investment cards where you think they're underpriced, or look for some of those traditional cards like Michael Jordan, where you think there's actually some room to improve. So, without further ado, we're gonna show you some of the mail that I've been getting that holds true to each one of these strategies. The first one is actually to buy lots of key rookies, right? And so with that, you're gonna wanna target guys that you think have a lot of investment potential and find listings on eBay where they're selling multiple cards of a particular player. So what I've got for you here is a mail day that I did where I got six Ronald Acuna rookie cards. Now these are ungraded rookie cards. This is from 2018 Topps Living. So you'll see I've got six different cards here, each one of the traditional Ronald Acuna Jr. rookie card. This is by no means his Topps update, the one that's going for, you know, several hundred dollars. This is a lower end set. This is one where I got these for $5 or $6 a piece. So a set that you could either do a couple different things with. I could flip these very quickly, right? And hope to make $6, $8, $10 and get a little bit of profit built up that way, especially if you're a newer investor. If you are in high school, say, this is a good way to do this, right? I could also take these cards and send them off to be graded. So a $6 investment card here, once you get it graded, this is $20, $25. You may want to wait for the market to pick back up a little bit more in terms of sports cards. And in, you know, a month or whatever it is when the season gets going again, these Ronald Acuna rookie cards are never a bad way to go. So right off the bat, buy lots and look for lots where you can maximize your dollar. Now, that's always fun to do, but sometimes I want to diversify my set. And so I think I've got three examples here of some overlooked ways to look at rookie cards and things like that where I think you can make a big difference. So I actually picked up a Luka Doncic. This is a Court Kings acetate card. This is not a rookie card, this is an insert card, but I think I got this for $20, $25, somewhere like that on eBay. I just love this card. I'm a big fan of anything acetate, anything clear behind it. This person actually was really nice and sent some extras. Knowing that I'm a Dallas Mavericks fan, they included a Dirk jersey card and a KP Panini Threads. This is numbered to 75. So again, nothing crazy with these two cards, but to get those for free, especially if you are a young collector, that is a super way to then be able to take those profits. Now, not everybody does this, right? But then also to look to these outside of the box thinking to get some cards and invest that way. Another way to do this is to buy cards that are from a second year player, right? Imagine if you could get a Michael Jordan or a Shaquille O'Neal second year card. Imagine you could get a Giannis Silver from his second year, or LeBron James from his second year. Those are all great ideas. Well, we've got this with Luka. right? And with Trey. So this is a revolution. This is a sunburst to 75. I picked this up on the cheap. I think I paid $60 or $65, something like that. But to get something that's low numbered, I'm actually doing the rainbow. So I'm doing what you're not supposed to do, which is also collect. So with these second year cards, I've got, right, the base version here. I've got the groove version here. I've got a lot of different options that I'm going to complete the rainbow, meaning getting all the different colored parallels. So not necessarily what you want to do, but you get the idea there with that second year card that there's still value that I think you can get there as well. The other way to do this is to look not for true rookie cards, but look for memorabilia cards, right? So here is a Luka first year Prism. This is his, it's called Sensational Swatches. It's not numbered or anything. These go for anywhere from $40 to $50, but if they're graded, this is a $200 card. And so, right, looking for those kind of below the radar, second year cards, mem cards, the offsets, not the prisms and the optics, those are great ways to be able to invest without, you know, kind of going on the radar. The third and final step is to really find deals. And of course, if you're looking on eBay listings, from time to time, you'll find things that either aren't priced according to market value, where you can make some money, or you need to look for cards that inherently have a little bit more value to them. So one of the ones that I just picked up, and this is definitely an investment card for me, is a Luka Rookie. This is a Select Tricolor. This is a BGS 9.5, so this is a Min Gem. Love this card, was able to get this for just under $200. It books anywhere from $200 to $225, somewhere in there right now. Really love this card. I actually bought this for myself as a PC, but you get the idea that with these, you're looking for something that's under the market value just a little bit, and then be able to sell this when the time comes. Say if the NBA season comes back in a couple months, this instantly will be worth a little bit more money. The other way to do that is to look at cards that maybe are a little bit more traditionally well-known. And so for that, we're gonna look to Michael Jordan cards. With these, you have to be a little bit more careful or more specific and look for cards that are condition sensitive. So here are a couple inserts from the 90s. This is a Michael Jordan. You can kind of maybe see it there in the camera. It's got that kind of holo cutout in the middle that when you're up close and you kind of put it in the light, it comes to light. And this is a die cut. You guys know I'm a sucker for die cuts. I've always wanted this card to be able to find this and to find it in good condition. I got this for $8 or $9. I got this for $6. So to be able to find some under the radar Michael Jordan inserts and to find them on the cheap, especially if they're condition sensitive, if I were to get these graded or to sell them in a couple weeks when the Last Dance documentary comes out, that's a great way to instantly be able to turn a quick profit from those cards. So that's gonna go ahead and do it for today's video. If you did like the video, go ahead and leave me a like, and in down in the comments section, tell me what cards you've invested in and flipped for a quick profit. We're gonna start transitioning a little bit more into talking about how to actually make money from the hobby. We've done a lot of the foundational work, so that's what's kind of coming next. So if you do like the comments, leave me a comment down below and tell me about that. And if you do like the content overall, be sure to hit that subscribe button, right? And go ahead and turn on the notification bell so that you can be notified when I go live with their new videos and new content. Really do want to help create a conversation and get things going. I am posting twice a week to be able to provide you content. So, hope you all do enjoy it, and until next time, keep your flip game strong.